Hello everybody, welcome to this Toxic Talk show. Today's podcast, we're going to talk about Bitcoin price and Bitcoin value. Because I realize a lot of people confuse the value of Bitcoin with the price. So they look at the chart and they say, oh, this is the how much Bitcoin worth. I know that's true, right, in terms of, like, you know, the market decide, right, how much this thing worth at the moment. But if you look at the value of the network, you know, the integrity and the community around it, right, the intelligence of all those people and what it sells, right? This thing is worth way more than what it is now. You know, I'm not even valuing Bitcoin in terms of paper money. You know, I look at Bitcoin in terms of, like, real commodity, like real gold, wood, real stuff in the real world, like precious stuff, like if you want to make, you have to work for. You know, the value of Bitcoin to me is the proof of work. You know, like that's a fundamental reason, like one of the fundamental reasons why I'm in Bitcoin, why I pay attention to it, is because of the proof of work, right? Because we live in a world where everybody is too lazy, right? Everybody is lazy. They just want quick fix, right? That's why you see so many people are drug addicts, right? So, everybody's lazy. They just want free money, right? So, that's why you see a bunch of them just moving to proof of stake, right? So, they just want to sit home and make money, right? Just sit on their ass and, producing money without any proof of work. You know, it's ironic to see how, like, you see the people, like the lazy people, right? They just go on the easy way. And the strong and, you know, hardworking ones, they move for proof of work. If you're a general labor and, you know, you're working hard to make your money and you have, like, $5 to save, would you save it in something that's easy to produce, or would you save it in something that is hard to produce? You would choose the hard way, you see. So this is how I look at it. Like, the price to me is just, like, you know, just a symbol, right? Just saying, okay, this is the price now. This is how much SAT I can get with the money now. But once you understand its value, its potential, then you start to realize, hey, this thing, you know, I just have to look how many SATs I can own. That's all, right? So you don't, like, I see a lot of people now start to value their wealth in terms of SATs, right? So, like, if you go on the Lightning Network, right? So, on the Lightning Network, so, if when you open a node, right? So, if you have 1 million sats, that's pretty good. You can open a, you know, a channel very easy, right? So, this way, a lot of people start to value their wealth in terms of sats, because now, if you have like 10 million sats, that will put you in a very big position, right? In the Lightning Network. Now you can basically, like, run a massive, like a big node. Like, you can run a big channel, right? Open a big channel and pull liquidity. So that's a great sign. So, see, people start to value the wealth in terms of SAT. Like, when I go on, you know, there's a website called yalts.org, So people just post, though, you know, they have a post, right? And then just a blog post, and then somebody read it and they find value and they pay them back. That's valuing your wealth in terms of sats, right? And in Satoshi, it's built on the Lightning Network. And you have stackers that news also on the Lightning Network, right? It doesn't matter if it's one sat or two sats. This one sat will worth way more in the future. So if you post something, right, on this platform, and you got, let's say, 1,000 sats, now you say, okay, that's not much, but in 10 years, that's gonna be a lot, right? If you leave that there for your kids, and you're in the future, right, you log in and you take it out, you take that 1,000 sats, right? It's a lot. So yeah, we start to value our wealth in terms of sats. Like anything else, it's a shit coin. Like the national currency is a shit coin. They can print millions and trillions overnight. Okay? So there's no value in those. The real value is our proof of work, our energy, our ability to go to work. Now, I'm driving to work right now, and I'm making this podcast. You see? So I use my time, okay? I could not find enough time to do that. So what I did, I just say, hey, when I'm going to work, you know, like, what am I doing? Right? Talking to myself. No, let's make a podcast. So, and if you guys find value, you want to send me some value back, right? If I save you from the shit coiners, right? If I save you a few hundred bucks, right? Instead of getting to this nonsense, shit coins, and you got like real sats, I get you to understand Bitcoin, and you start accumulating sats, and you better off yourself, then that's a good thing, right? You may decide to, you know, stream me some sats back, or you may just decide to keep your sats for yourself, okay? So that's the point. So basically, yeah, I just wanted to throw this out there, guys. Just, I hope you enjoy, okay? And again, stack sats, stay humble. And you don't have to go and fight and on Twitter, on all this like nonsense, YouTube. You don't have to go through all that, right? Just stack sats, stay humble, and just, you know, look, you know, just value, start valuing your wealth in terms of sats. And because sats is proof of work, it's hard to produce, right? So, and here's the problem with those proof of stake people. Here's what they don't understand, you know? Like, when you have proof of work, right? The Bitcoin proof of work network, to mine Bitcoin or to produce Bitcoin, you have to basically invest your money, like, at front, right? Okay? So, you have to put money in, right? In the real world, okay? So this is what we're so good about Bitcoin, because Bitcoin touches the real world, right? So those altcoins, those proof of stakes, they don't touch the real world, right? They just operate within them. So you have a mass, you have a like a bunch of coin you create, right? Pre-mine, a bunch of people hold some, right? Without doing any work, just because they have the authority to hold some. And then you have another bunch of people who have to get some, because but they have to, in order to get some, they have to just take that the coin they own, right, they bought, to put it in, to give it to this like big wealth, right, so they can stick and they can give them a few back. Think about it, right? So in a system like this, right, if the person, right, the person have so much, if they are devaluing the coins, how do you know? How do you find out? Right? Because they're just devaluing the coin. So it's a massive scam. And people think to fall for it again. You know, like, people are so stupid to fall for anything. Like, it's just like, ironic. Like, anything they fall for, like, any stupid things, you just show people, you tell, hey, you can make money, they will fall for it. It's just like why? So this is it. Like, people understand, like, when people go mine Bitcoin, right? You have to afford, you have to spend money, right? So this is where all this money coming out of in the real world, all this investment are the, like, they're injection of money from outside the world, right? You know, when you move from proof of work, right, to proof of stake, you basically remove that incoming money flow, right, to this network. You cut that off. So you see, only money that's gonna come into the network is the, you know, you're hoping on promotion, right? New people coming in, right? You want to try to get people like a new, like all those new tricks. You're gonna tell them to do this, do that. You're gonna get more. It's gonna be more valuable. You know, all more, those marketing gonna get worse and worse, right? They're gonna come with all sort of tricks, all sort of lies to tell people, oh, get in, get in. Oh, you know, it's gonna pump. It's gonna be 10,000. It's gonna be all those things. They have to push that more and more now. Because the only thing, the only value in this network is for new people coming in. You see? So with Bitcoin, it doesn't need that. I just need a like difficulty adjustment. If, you know, less people are mining, less people are putting money in, it just you know, we adjust the, you know, the difficulty, right? It lowered the difficulty. If more people are getting it adjusted to higher difficulty. You see? So anyways, to me, this is really simple to understand, to see, because I have engineering background. I spent 2 years in school of engineering, so I can see that, like, what's going on. But for the average Joe, it's very hard for them to understand. And this is why I'm creating this, is to help you guys understand what's going on, because it's a massive scam. You know, when you see the price going up, that doesn't mean that the value of the thing going up. Right? So it's the same thing for Bitcoin. You see the price going down, that doesn't mean the value of the thing going down. That means it's so cheap now, right? Like, people don't understand if it's cheap, right? So it's an opportunity for you to get in and hold it, and then just let it rise up. But my best strategy is DCA, you know, just DCA, and just ignore the noise. Right? So this was a toxic talk for today. I'm gonna get in. Okay, so okay guys, I hope you enjoy. Just support the channel, and again, I love, I'm keep gonna ask, you know, like, if you find value, just send some value back, and this will help me keep going. So, and send you know, just do those podcasts. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you again, guys. This was Spike Over. See you in the next Toxic Talk.